إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد
anything and he forgives what is less than that to whom he wills. قال ابن كثير أي من الذنوب لمن يشاء يعني any sin which is smaller than that for whom he wills. According to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, he said, كُنْتُ أَرِدْفَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ عَلَى حِمَارٍ يُقَالَ لَهُ عُفَيْرٌ. I was with the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم on the same mount as he was, a donkey, which was called Ufair. And he said, يَا مُعَاذ, هَلْ تَدْرِي حَقَّ اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ عِبَادِي. He said, oh Mu'adh, do you know what Allah's right is over His servants? وَمَا حَقُّ الْعِبَادِ عَلَىٰ اللَّهِ. And what the slave or the servant's rights are over Allah. قُلْتُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ وَعَلَمْ. I said, Allah and His Messenger know best. قال فإن حق الله على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. That the right that Allah has over His slaves is that they should worship Him and associate nothing with Him. وحق العباد على الله أن لا يعذب من لا يشرك به شيئا. And the right that the slave has over Allah is that he will not punish anyone who does not associate anything with him. فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَفَلَا أُبَشِّرُ بِهِ النَّاسِ. I said, O Messenger of Allah, should I not give this glad tidings to the people? قَالَ لَا تُبَشِّرْهُمْ فَيَتَّكِلُوا. He said, do not inform them, for surely they will depend on it alone. This was collected by both Bukhari and Muslim. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he clarifies an aspect of this hadith where it mentions the right that the servant has over Allah. And he says, كَوْنُ الْمُطِيعِ يَسْتِحِقُّ الْجَزَاءِ هُوَ إِسْتِحْقَاقُ إِنْعَامٍ وَفَضْلٍ. The fact that the one who obeys deserves this reward, it is an act of kindness and grace from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ هُوَ إِسْتِحْقَاقُ مُقَابَلًا. It is not this type of right that you have where you reciprocate it because of something that you do. He says, كَمَا يَسْتِحِقُّ الْمَخْلُوقُ عَلَى الْمَخْلُوقُ. The same way one human being has a right over another human being. It's not like that with Allah. وأهل السنة يقولون هو الذي كتب على نفسه الرحمة وأوجب هذا الحق على نفسه. And the people of the Sunnah, they say it is Allah who has decreed upon Himself mercy and has prescribed this right over His own self. ولم يوجبه عليه مخلوق. No human being has actually forced this upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول شيخ الثامين رحمه الله تعالى as he explains this, he says تحقيق التوحيد يعني staying away from shirk means actualizing توحيد. And he says actualizing توحيد requires that you stay away from sins. That you stay away from sins. He said لأن المعاصي صادرة عن الهوى. Because sins, the root of sins, are you following your desire. وَهَذَا نَوْعٌ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. And this is the type of shirk, yani associating partners with Allah قال تعالى أفرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هوى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, have you not seen the one who has taken his desires as his Lord? And truly we have seen this in ourselves. Whenever a command comes, whether from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether from Allah or His Messenger, and we go intentionally against it because we feel or desire something, we have made our desires an ilah, a Lord. Jabir ibn Abdullah, he said, Ata, a man came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَنْ مُوْجِبَتَانِ. What are the compulsory two things, or which would necessitate certain things? فَقَالَ مَنْ مَاتَ لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever dies not associating anything with Allah shall enter paradise. وَمَنْ مَاتَ يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا دَخَلَ النَّارِ. And whoever dies associating anything with Allah, he shall enter the fire. Now, it doesn't mention whether it's big or small, anything, no matter what it is. يقول النووي, and Nawawi mentions when it says in the hadith, مَنْ مُوْجِبَتَانِ, what are those two compulsory or necessary things? He says, يعني, what is intended here, الْخَصْلَ الْمُوْجِبَ لِلْجَنَّةِ وَالْخَصْلَ الْمُوْجِبَ لِلْنَارِ. What are the two characteristics that will require you required to have to enter paradise, and what will put you in the fire? The first one is tawheed. If you have perfect tawheed, you have perfect success in terms of the life to come. But if you have any shirk, then that promise is taken away from you and you're on your way to the fire. أنواع التوحيد التي يقع فيها شرك. There are different types of tawheed, or different categories of tawheed. النوع الأول توحيد الربوبية والملك. The first aspect of tawheed is what we call توحيد الربوبية والملك. The tawheed of lordship and dominion. وهو الإقرار بأن الله تعالى رب كل شيء ومالكه وخالقه ورازقه وأن المحي والمميت. النافع والضار المتفرد بإجابة الدعاء عند الاضطرار الذي له الأمر كله وبيده الخير كله القادر على ما يشاء ليس له في ذلك شريك. توحيد الربوبية. It is the acknowledgement that Allah alone is the Lord of everything that exists. That He is His sovereign, His creator, its sustainer, the one who gives life and causes death, the one who benefits and harm. He is singled out with answering supplications when a person needs. الَّذِي لَهُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ, in whose hand he has the charge of every affair. وَبِيَدِ الْخَيْرُ كُلُّهُ, and in his hand is all good. القادر على ما يشاء, the one who has the ability to do whatever he wills. ليس له في ذلك الشريك, he has no companion in this area. ويدخل في ذلك الإيمان بالقدر, and included in this is your faith in decree. وهذا التوحيد, this aspect of توحيد, لا يكفي إلا في حصول الإسلام. If you have this type of tawheed, that is not sufficient for you to enter into this deen of ours. If you believe everything I said just now, all of those qualities and attributes, and you stop there, you are not a Muslim. Says, بَلْ لَعْبُرَ يَأْتِيَ مَعَ ذَلِكْ بِلَازِمِهِ مِنْ تَوْحِيدَ الْإِلَهِيَّ أَوْ أُلُوهِيَّ أَوْ الْعِبَادَةِ. لأن الله تعالى حكى عن المشركين أنهم مقرون بهذا التوحيد لله وحده. He said, this particular explanation comes from a book called Taysir Aziz al-Hamid, which is an explanation of Kitab al-Tawheed. And the author, he mentions, he says here, in addition to having Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, you must come with that which is inseparable to it. And that is Tawheed al-Ilahiyyah or Uluhiyyah or Ibadah. And this is Tawheed of worship. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He speaks about the polytheists, the idol worshippers in Mecca, He mentions that they acknowledge Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, that Allah is the creator, Allah is the sustainer, Allah is the one who gives life, Allah is the one who causes death, Allah is in charge of everything in the heavens and the earth. فَقَالَ تَعَالَىٰ قُلْ مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَمَّنْ يَمْلِكُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ فَسَيَقُولُونَ اللَّهُ فَقُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say, who is it that gives you sustenance from the heavens and the earth? Who it is that has dominion over your hearing and your sight? Who is it who brings out of life, brings life out of that which is dead, and death out of that which is living? And who arranges all affairs? They shall say Allah. If you ask these idol worshippers all of these things, they will say Allah. فَقُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Then say to them, then you will not have fear and receive righteousness. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ فَأَنَّا يُفَكُونَ. And if you were to question and ask them who created them, they will say Allah. Then how is it that they turn away? فَهُمْ كَانِ يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ جَمِيعَ ذَلِكَ لِلَّهِ وَحْدَهُ وَلَمْ يَكُونُ بِذَلِكَ مُسْلِمِينَ. They knew all of this was supposed to be directed to Allah alone, and this was not sufficient for them to become Muslims. They were not Muslims. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Most of them don't believe in Allah except that they commit shirk. And so that element of committing shirk and having only this type of tawheed alone kept them out of the folds of this deen. قال مجاهد في الآية إيمانهم بالله قولهم إن الله خلقنا ويرزقنا ويميتنا فهذا إيمان مع شرك عباده بهم غيره. He says, Mujahid, the student of Ibn Abbas, when he explained this verse, he said that iman was the belief that Allah created us. They're saying that Allah sustained us, that Allah is the one who causes us to die. This iman with shirk was their act of worship. This was their deen. وَمِنْ أَنْوَاعِ الشِّرْكِ فِي الرُّبُوبِيَّةِ شِرْكُ تَعْطِيلِ. And there are characteristics or aspects of shirk in rububiyyah. And one is denial or rejection. And this is the worst type of shirk in this area. This is like the shirk of Fir'aun. This is like the shirk of Fir'aun. إِذْ قَالَ وَمَا رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And who is the Lord of all that exists? A type of criticism. وَمِنْ هَذَا الشِّرْكِ شِرْكُ الْفَلَاسِفَةِ. And like this type of shirk is the shirk or the shirk of the philosophers. القائلين بقدم العالم والأبديته. Those who say that what you see out there was always there. Yani all that exists out there was always there. Eternally. والحوادث بأسرها. وأنه لم يكن معدوما أصلا. And it never was in a state of nothingness. This was their يعني denial of rububiyya totally. بَلَمْ يَزَالْ وَلَا يَزَالْ وَالْحَوَادِثْ بِأَسْرِهَا مُسْتَنِدَ عِنْدُهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَسْبَابٍ وَوَسَائِبٍ اِقْتَدَتْ إِجَادُهَا أو إِجَادَهَا. He says, and with them, they believe that creation is related to causes and other means that brought them into existence. That's shirk in rububiyya, because Allah is the creator. وَمَنْ شِرْكْ فِي الرُّبُوبِيَةِ شِرْكْ أُولَاتْ عُبَادِ الْقُبُورِ. And of the shirk in this area, and the shirk that we find amongst the Muslims in this day and time.
This is your?
This is the shirk that we find amongst the Muslims in this day and time. The shirk of those who... وَيَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّ أَرْوَاحَ الْأَوْلِيَاءِ تَتَصَرَّفْ بَعْضَ الْمَوْتِ. And they claim that the soul of the saints acts and arrange the affairs after death. فَيَقَضُونَ الْحَاجَاتِ. They fulfill the needs of people. وَيُفَرِّجُونَ الْقُرُبَاتِ. and they remove distress. وَيَنْصُرُونَ مَنْ دَعَاهُمْ and they help those who call on them. وَيَحْفَظُونَ مَنْ اِلْتَجَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَاذَ بِحِمَاهُمْ and that whoever seeks protection with them and seek assistance, they will help them. فَإِنَّ هَذِي مِنْ خَصَائِصِ الرُّبُوبِيَّةِ these are specific to rububiyyah, يعني that is for Allah alone. And this is something that exists as we speak amongst hundreds, maybe thousands of Muslims. Or should I say hundreds of thousands of Muslims. Look, when you have in a Muslim country, Muslims making pilgrimage to the tomb of a saint, that's bad. But when you know that the saint that they're making pilgrimage to is a Hindu, it makes it worse. But that is the state of affairs because of people going away from Tawheed and not understanding the foundations of the deen. The thing that will allow you to enter paradise. وَمِنَ اللَّهِ التَّوْحِيدِ تَوْحِيدُ الْأَسْمَى وَالصِّفَاتِ And of the areas of Tawheed is the Tawheed of Asma wa Sifat, unity of Allah's names and attributes. وَأَصْلُ هَذَا الْبَابِ كَمَا قَالَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِنْ تَيْمِيَّ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى The basis of this particular area is like what Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said. He says, وَمِنَ الْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ And now the characteristics of faith in Allah. الْإِيمَان بِمَا وَصَفَ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ فِي كِتَابِهِ وَوَصَفَهُ بِهِ رَسُولُهُ مُحَمَّد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من غير تحريف ولا تعطيل من غير تكييف ولا تمثيل. He says, and of the iman, of having iman in Allah, is having iman in what Allah or how Allah describes Himself in His book, and how the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam described Him, without any change of the text, without any denial of the text. Without saying how in respect to Allah's attributes, without any total likening or likeness to His creation, this all is supposed to not be there. بَلْ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ But for the believers, they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing whatsoever like Him, and He is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. Yani, no matter what you have in your head, you cannot conceive the creator of the heavens and the earth. Any imagery that you have, you have already committed shirk. Any type of likeness that crosses your mind and you play around with it in your head, you're playing around with shirk. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ There is nothing whatsoever like Him. So the people on the sunnah, the people of Iman, لا ينفون عنه ما وصف به نفسه. They do not negate what Allah or how Allah describes Himself. ولا يحرفون الكلمة عن مواضعه. And they do not distort the apparent meanings that you find in the text. If Allah says He has a face, He has a face. If He says He has a hand, He has a hand. You don't go and give some outside meaning, power, or reward. The people who follow the text, they don't do that. They accept it as it is. So they don't do this. وَلَا يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ And they do not deviate in respect to Allah's names. وَآيَاتِ and His signs. وَلَا يُكَيِّفُونَ وَلَا يُمَثِّلُونَ صِفَاتِهِ بِصِفَاتِ خَلْقِهِ And they do not mention any likeness or similitude of Allah's creation and liken Allah to His creation in this regard. لِأَنَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ لَا سَمِيَّ لَهُ وَلَا كُفَّ لَهُ وَلَا نِدَّ لَهُ وَلَا يُقَاسُ بِخَلْقِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing, He has no likeness and no similarity, no equal. And you cannot have any analogy from His creation to measure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. فَإِنَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ أعلم بنفسه وبغيره وأصدق قيلا وأحسن حديثا من خلقه Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He has more knowledge of Himself and more knowledge of everybody else than themselves And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most truthful in speech, the most eloquent in his presentation than any of his creation. ثُمَّ رُسُلُهُ أَصَّادِقُونَ الْمَسْتُقُونَ. And then after that, his messengers who are truthful and believe. Those who came with the truth and only speak the truth. بِخِلَافِ الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ عَلَيْهِ مَا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Not like those who say about Allah that which they do not know. Shaykh al-Islam, he says, فَلِهَذَا قَالَ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ عَمَّا يَسِفُونَ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ فَسَّبَّحَ نَفْسَهُ عَمَّا وَصَفَهُ الْخَالِفُونَ لِلرُّسُلِ وَسَلَّمْ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ لِسَلَامَةِ مَا قَالُهُ مِنَ النَّقْصِ وَالْعَيْبِ. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Subhana Rabbika, Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifun. Subhana is a statement of Tawheed. What it means is Tanzihu Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala min naqais wal uyub. That it's an exclamation which recognizes that Allah is above and high of any imperfection and fault. When you say Subhana or Subhanallah, it's an acknowledgement that Allah is perfect, He has no defects, no faults, no blemish, nothing. It's an expression of Tawheed. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this about Himself. Subhana Rabbika, Lord of Izzah, of power and might, above what they describe. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ. And peace and security on the messengers. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all that exists. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, so Allah praises Himself, glorifies Himself as being above how those who show opposition to the messengers describe Him. And He sends peace on the messengers because of the soundness of what they say and being free of deficiency and defect. Tahrif then. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he summarizes in those few lines the creed of the people of the Sunnah in respect to Allah's names and attributes. In respect to Allah's names and attributes. And the first thing, yani Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, he clarifies some of this for you. Makes it clear for you. Tahrif. One of the things we don't do, we don't change the meaning or the expression. None of it. If you want the Sunnah, you accept it as it is. فَأَهْلُ السُنَّةِ وَالْجُمَعَ إِيمَانَهُمْ. The people of the Sunnah, their faith in how Allah describes Himself is free of any distortion or changing, whether it's changing the meaning or the expression in the text. You don't do any type of change. And also, with ta'qir, there is no making bare and empty, yani denying of anything that Allah or the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't deny anything, no matter how big or small. With takyif, and you don't say how. When Ibn Battuta said that he saw Ibn Taymiyyah coming down off the minbar describing how Allah descends, he was a kadhab. If you don't know what kadhab means, it means a liar. No, a professional liar. A professional liar. When he entered the place, Ibn Taymiyyah was in jail. He never came out, he died in jail. When did he see him? When did he see him? Not only that, it wasn't known that he gave no khutbas like that anyway. Kadhab, no, kadhub. You know, when you're a kadhab, you're a professional liar. When you're kadhub, that's all you do is lie. Here, we don't say how. We don't do that. We accept it as it is. If you say, for example, yani, I saw someone walking like such and such, and you describe his steps, right? You know, some of our brothers, they got a bop. You move, you know, he moves his shoulder, he moves such and such. You describe it because you've seen him. And if he's not there, you see someone like him, you could say, no, man, he's like that over there. Or someone comes and inform you and they can depict him because there's some type of similitude somewhere. The Sheikh, he says, فَكَيْفِيَ تُشَيْءٍ. How something is. لَا تُدْرَكْ إِلَّا بِوَاحِدٍ مِنْ أُمُورٍ ثَلَاثَةٍ. If you want to know how something is, it can only be realized if you have one of three things in place. مُشَاهَدَتُهُ, you've seen it. Or مَشَاهَدَتُ نَذِيرِهِ, or you've seen something like it. Or خَبَرُ الصَّادِقْ عَنْهُ, or you have the information of someone who is truthful informing you. Now, how many people have seen Allah? Don't raise your hands. Right? If you've seen something like Allah, or someone comes and informs you and tell you how it is, if these things are absent, how you can say kaif? How? Biduni kaif. So we don't do that. And what this means, it doesn't mean that we don't believe that there is a certain way. It's just that we don't know. We don't know. We don't deny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does what He describes concerning Himself in a certain way. We as human beings don't know. We ain't seen Him. We haven't seen anything like Him. We don't know anybody who's seen Him to inform us about those particulars. So we accept it as it is. وَالْتَمْثِيلِ, and we do not liken Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His creation in any way. Yani there, you hear the words tamthil and you hear the words tashbih. Tamthil is when you liken Allah to His creation in every which way with no difference. Right? If you've seen Allah walking on the streets of Chicago, you liken Him to it. You liken Allah to a human being in every which way. Right? If you say that Allah has this quality on this area and some like this, in some ways this is tashbih, you're liking Him partially. All of those things are incorrect in respect to how we view Allah's names and attributes. All of them. Okay? Now, one of the things the Shaykh says here, he says, فَإِنَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ أَعْلَمْ بِنَفْسِهِ وَبِغَيْرِهِ وَأَسْتَقُوا قِيلًا وَأَحْسَنُوا حَدِيثًا مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has more knowledge about Himself and about everybody else than they know about themselves. And He is the most truthful in speech, the most eloquent in His discourse above His creation. Shaykh Uthaymeen, he says, when Ibn Taymiyyah deals like this in respect to Allah, he says, this is a preparation and an introduction as to the reasons why we accept the text in respect to Allah's qualities, in respect to Allah's names as they are. Why we accept them as they are. And he says here, إِذَا سَمْعَتْ, a person, when they inform you about something, the information, if it has four things in it, then you know you got to accept it. He says the first thing, أَنْ يَكُونَ صَادِرًا عَنْ عِلْمٍ, that it's based on knowledge. Right? وَإِلَيْهِ لِشَارِ بِقَوْلِ فَإِنْهُ أَعْلَمُ بِنَفْسِهِ وَبِغَيْرِهِ. And this is what Shaykh al-Islam was intending when he says, because Allah has more knowledge about Himself and about everybody else than everybody else has about themselves. So the first thing, when Allah tells you about Himself, is based on ilm, is based on knowledge. Secondly, as-sidq. You know anybody more truthful than Allah? No. And then, You have knowledge. And what Allah says about Himself is total truth. And what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after that says is total truth. وَالْوَصْفُ الثَّانِي الْبَيَانِ وَالْفَصَاحَةِ. Secondly, in terms of being clear and eloquent about what He intends to express to His creation, nobody is more clear and more eloquent than Allah. No one can make it plainer than Allah makes it plain. وَأَشَارَ إِلَيْهِ بِقَوْلِ وَأَحْسَنُ حَدِيثًا. And no one is best in his narrative than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Shaykh mentions something else that is found in the Quran. وَسَلَامَةُ الْقَصْدِ وَالْإِرَادَ. And that you have soundness of intent and will. بِأَنْ يُرِيدَ الْمُخْبِرُ هِدَايَةَ مَنْ أَخْبَرَهُ. That the person who is informing you, he has good intention and good will in respect to those that he's speaking to. Allah mentions in the Quran, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ وَيَهْدِيَكُمْ سُنَنَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. That Allah intends to make clear to you and to guide you in the pathways of those who were before you. So when Allah teaches us, the intent, first of all, is to make it clear and to give you guidance. So if we have all of these things in place, we have al-ilm, knowledge. You have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being the most truthful, the most eloquent, and He intends guidance for you in making things clear for you. If all of these things are in place, then why are you not accepting the text as it appears in the book and in the sunnah? Why do you give it some hidden meaning? Like you're going to break it down better than Allah breaks it down. Or you're going to come with something so deep that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't have. You know, Sufis are good at this. Right? Salah is no longer you're saying Allahu Akbar and saying As-Salaamu Alaikum. No man, Salam is when your heart turns in the direction of Allah. You don't got to bow like that. That's the Sharia. What we got is the Tariqah. That's for the common folks. These are for the deep brothers and sisters. So they come. They come with a message. That underlining that message is doing away with what we have in the Quran and Sunnah. And it's a criticism against Allah and His Messenger. They didn't make it plain. We're going to make it plain for you. When the verses explain away the names and attributes, it may sound deep, but it's deep in misguidance. And this is why the methodology of the people on the Sunnah, أَمِرُوهَا كَمَا جَاءَتْ بِلَا كَيْفِ. You accept the text as it is without saying how. That's the methodology of the people on the Sunnah. So we accept it in this way. And then the Shaykh goes on, he says, and the messengers who have been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sadiqun wal-Masduqun. Al-Masduq, this is the person who informs of the truth and the one who comes with the truth. So all of these things, yani if you liken Allah to His creation, you have committed shirk. If you do it totally or partially, if you start talking about how, you've committed shirk. How Allah descends. You have committed shirk. If you deny Allah's names and attributes, you have committed shirk. حيث جعل الحي القيوم كالمعدوم. Shaykh Uthaymeen, he says, because you liken the living, the one who's in charge of everything, like one that does not exist. Right? You know, they have some people, right? They say, look, it's haram for you to say Allah is above. It's haram for you to say Allah is above. Yep, that's what they say. But we know, and they say, look, you can't say Allah is above. You can't say He's beneath you. He's not to the right of you. He's not to the left of you. He's not behind you, and He's not in front of you. Then where is He? Look, one of the Salaf says, if you wanted to describe nothingness, you could not do it better than giving that description. It ain't above, not beneath, not right, left, front, behind, nowhere. It don't exist. But that is a byproduct of going outside of the methodology of the Salaf and coming up with your own philosophy from your back pocket. That's what that is. Because all, look, Amintu man fis sama. Allah asked the question, do you feel safe against the one who's above the sky? Allah was speaking about the angels. يَخَافُونَ رَبَّهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ. They fear their Lord who is above them. Look, you've ever heard about Baytul Ma'mur? Baytul Ma'mur is that bait up there, up in the sky. 70,000 angels go around it every day, and a new 70,000 come. That's pretty high up. This verse says Allah is above all of them. That's the Quran. And they say, you can't do it. Allah's messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith of Mu'awiyah bin Hakam al-Sulami, he asked the servant girl, ain't Allah? Where is Allah? If the question was wrong, Allah's messenger would not have posed the question. And the response, fistama, yani up there, above. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a'tiqha fa'innaha mu'mina fiyya, because she truly believes. Not only acknowledged it, but pointed out that this was a yardstick of the correctness of a creed. Tayyib. The other area where people commit shirk is in Tawheed al-Uluhiyya or Tawheed al-Ibadah. Tawheed al-Ibadah. When these two expressions are used, and we've heard them before, al-Uluhiyya is used when you're actually referring to Allah Himself. But when you're speaking about how we direct our affairs to Allah, our subservience is Tawheed al-Ibadah, or Tawheed of worship. Because we are the ones worshiping. Allah worships nobody. So when we speak about Tawheed al-Ibadah, we're speaking about having all acts of worship directed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Uluhiyya, speaking about Allah having that quality of deserving to be worshipped alone. Okay? So, Tawheed, this type of Tawheed, is having sincere devotion to Allah alone, min al-mahabba wal-khawf, of love and fear, of raja, hope, wa tawakkul, depending on Allah totally, wa rahba, wa rahba, ayna, having desire and awe, وَالدُّعَى لِلَّهِ وَحْدَ, supplicating to Allah alone. On this is based إخلاص العبادة or إخلاص العبادات كلها ظاهرها وباطنها لله وحده لا شريك له. And on this is based all acts of worship that we do. That it should be sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That which is inward and that which is outward. No partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing, whether you're speaking about an angel or you're speaking about a prophet that has been sent, nothing, not to speak about other than them. They don't deserve a bit of worship, none of them. Hadha tawheed. Huwa alladhi tadammanahu qawluhu ta'ala iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. This aspect of tawheed is included in what we recite. In all of the prayers, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. You alone, O Allah, do we worship. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And you alone, it is your assistance that we seek. هَذَا التَّوْحِيدُ وَأَوَّلُ الدِّينُ وَآخِرُهُ. This is the first of the deen and the last of it. It is the hidden and the open aspect of the deen. وَهُوَ دَعْوَةَ الرُّسُلِ This is the da'wah of the anbiya, of the messengers. And it is the آخِرُهَا, the first and the last of it. وَمَعْنَ قَوْلِهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And in this tawheed you have the meaning La ilaha illallah. Nothing deserves to be worshipped other than Allah. فَإِنَّ الْإِلَهُ هُوَ الْمَأْلُوَ الْمَعْبُودِ بِالْمَحَبَّ وَالْخَشَّةِ وَالْإِجْلَالِ وَتَعْذِيمِ Because the one that is worshipped, the one who deserves reverence, he is the one who is submitted to in a state of love and fear, respect and glorification. وَجَمِيعُ أَنْوَاعِ الْعِبَادَةِ And all aspects of worship. Everything. لِأَجْلِ هَذَا التَّوْحِيدِ Is because of this tawheed. Look. It is because of this tawheed that Allah created the universe, man. Because of this area of tawheed, Allah created what we see around us. And it is because of this tawheed that messengers were sent and books were revealed. وَبِيَفْتَرَقَ النَّاسِ إِلَى مُؤْمِنِينَ وَكُفَّارِ And based on this tawheed, people are kuffar or believers. سُعَدَى أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَأَشْقِيَا أَهْلِ النَّارِ Those who are happy in paradise and should be wretched in the fire. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى Allah mentions in the Quran, يَا أَيُّوَ النَّاسِ اُعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Allah says, mankind, worship your Lord who created you and those before you so that you may attain righteousness. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى The brother Shaykh says, فَهَذَا أَوْلُ الْأَمْرِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ فِي الْقُرْآنِ This is the first command in the Qur'an. The first command that you get in the book of Allah is ibadah, worship Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have created the jinn and mankind for no other reason other than to worship. This is the purpose of creation. To worship Allah. Yani look, we may have all types of things we want to achieve in this dunya. But no matter what our ideals and objectives are, if they contradict with the purpose for which Allah has created us, we have to step back and give it up. You're going against the reason why Allah created you for what? And eventually you're going to have to stand before Him and give an account. This is the purpose here. And the Shaykh says, it is the first compulsory act and it is the last compulsory act. It is what causes you to come into Islam, and it is the last thing you go out with in this dunya. The Prophet ﷺ mentions the person's last statement. It's this statement of tawheed, that La ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. He has entered paradise. And there's a virtue in the expressions, either in the Quran or in the Sunnah. When you use the past tense of the verb, it indicates something as if it has already been actualized. يعني تحقق الوقوع It is already as if you're floating around in Jannah now. If your tawheed is complete. It's almost as if you're already there looking at your bait, man. Look, the last person in paradise, he got this dunya in 10 times more. That's the one who's last. Right? Now he lasts. This dunya is pretty, it ain't that small. Right? But your bait man and your turf on that side 10 times more, and you're the last one? What you think about the brothers and sisters who used to exert themselves in righteousness? We can't imagine what Allah has in store for them. And this is why the Prophet said, what is in it is what no eye has seen. No ear has heard, and it has not even crossed upon the hearts of human beings. Not even that. The Shaykh, he says, فَمَنْ أَحَبَّ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ بِالتَّذَلُّ لَهُ وَالْخُضُوعِ وَالتَّعْذِيمِ فَقَدْ أَشْرَكَ Now these are some aspects that take you out of tawheed ul-ibadah into shirk. So whoever loves other than Allah in a state of lowliness, in humility and glorification, he has committed shirk. If you love someone like this, you have committed shirk. وَمَنْ خَافَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ. And whoever fears other than Allah, خَوْفَ السِّرْ. This type of private and hidden fear. And the Shaykh explained what is intended by خَوْفُ السِّرْ. وَيَخَافَ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُصِيبَهُ بِمَكْرُوهٍ بِمَشِئَتِهِ وَقُدْرَتِهِ وَإِنْ لَمْ يُبَاشِرْهُ فَهَذَا شِرْكٌ أَكْبَرٌ. And what is intended by this is that a person has fear that something or someone can afflict him with something harmful, with his will and power, even though he doesn't do anything. Right? And a lot of us got that fear about the jinns. Right? And some other stuff. And this is why you find some people, man, they'll lie. Wallahi! You ain't give me no money. It's swear by your sheikh, huh? And they start, you know, backing up, and because the reverence that they have for the sheikh is more than Allah. The sheikh says, لِأَنُّ اِعْتِقَاد. This is shirk. Why? Because it is a belief, لِلنَّفْعِ وَالضَّرْفِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ, that there's someone other than Allah can harm or benefit you. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Allah says, فَإِيَّايَ فَرْحَبُونَ. So if you want to have awe of someone, have it of me. وَمِنَّ الرَّجَاءِ فِيمَا لَا يَقْدِرْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Having hope for someone other than Allah with something that only Allah can accomplish. Like the one who calls on the dead or others that other than the dead, hoping that he will get what he hopes for from this person or this thing. That is major shirk. وَمَنْ دَعَى غَيْرَ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ عَبَدَهُ. Whoever supplicates to other than Allah has worshipped him. قَالَ تَعَالَى وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. And your Lord said, worship me and I shall respond and answer you. Those who disdain from my worship, they shall enter Jahannam in a state of disgrace. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, dua is worship. So whoever does any of these things and directed to other than Allah, he has committed shirk. Al-dhabh, when you sacrifice, and you say in the name of Jilani, you want tawheed, right? You want tawheed, right? Oh, okay. No, you're not. Allah mentions in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Allah says, say, surely my prayer and my sacrifice, when you slaughter something, and my living and my dying is for Allah, Lord of all that exists. He has no partners. And this I have been commanded with, and I am the first of those who submit. And nusuk wa dhabh. Nusuk here refers to sacrifice. So if you do this out of reverence or directed to anyone else, you have committed shirk. And nadhr wa tawaf, wa tawbah wa isti'adha wa istighatha. Any of these things, you take a pledge. You go around something for barakah, like you go around the Kaaba. Or you seek repentance from other than Allah, or isti'adha, seeking refuge in other than Allah, in a way that only Allah can help you. Or istighatha in times of difficulty, something that only Allah supports, you go into a human being, all of that is shirk. فَمَنْ أَشْرَكَ بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَبَيْنَ مَخْلُوقٍ فِيمَا يَخْتَصُّ بِالْخَالِقِ تَعَالَى مِنْ هَذِي الْعِبَادَاتِ أَوْ غَيْرِهَا فَهُوَ مُشْرِكٌ. And whoever commits or associates between Allah and His creation in any of these acts of worship, he is a mushrik, he is a polytheist. Brothers and sisters, I don't think we're going to be able to finish. the whole discussion, inshallah, maybe what we'll do is a follow-up, inshallah, to complete the whole discussion, because we have some other areas to deal with. But right now, we're going over the time, so we'd like to close here, inshallah. Look, what will save you is tawheed. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِذُلٍّ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Allah says in the Quran, those who believe and do not cover their faith with dhulm. In the hadith it mentions dhulm here is shirk. They shall have security. And they are the ones who guide it. Shaykhul Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, look, total security and safeness in the life to come is for total tawheed. So if you want to be safe on the other side, then we need to have no aspect of shirk in our lives, and then we'll get on the other side safely, inshallah. Oh, yeah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. If you have a written question that you want to set up, write it down, set it up, barakallahu feekum. If you don't sweat yourself.